This tiny little white plate that looks like something a dentist uses to ruin your childhood is a peltier, or thermal electric cooler. It's a little device that uses electricity via magic to make one side get super hot and the other side get super cold. Here's one running with a banshee cooler, where the cold side's gotten so cold there's a bunch of frost building up on it and everything. An effect which I tried to use to cool a graphics card in a previous video, but that was a complete disaster. It's immediately overheating. Oh, it's crashed. I think it's crashed. But today, I've got a different strategy. Instead of strapping this between a GPU and its cooler, I'm gonna try and use it to cool the liquid in a custom loop, which I think is a much better idea. Now my plan here is to take a custom loop that's cooling a graphics card. I'm gonna keep the radiator in there so that the custom loop can handle the thermal load on its own. And then I'm just gonna splice a peltier in there to drop the temperatures lower. Now, as far as I understand how a peltier works, this should be a better implementation than just sandwiching it against a die. Because apparently, peltiers don't like rapid temperature changes. They want a consistent temperature to deal with, which sounds a lot like the liquid in a custom loop. But the question here is, how do we get the peltier to interact with the liquid inside the loop? Well, I've had a couple of plans. Now, plan number one was to use an AIO to cool the hot side of the peltier, so that it removes that heat from the loop, it doesn't have to fight itself. And then I add a heatsink to the cold side of the peltier and dip that heatsink into the reservoir of the custom loop. This way, we also increase the surface area that's actually contacting the liquid. But I'm not a huge fan of this idea because it's just gonna lead to me electrocuting myself. Now, the second idea I had was to try and somehow attach the peltier to the radiator, because I felt like the radiator is already thermally conductive and it's got a lot of surface area actually contacting the liquid in the loop. And then I just have the AIO cooling that. But my engineering wizard friend was not convinced by this plan, because he was saying there was too much thermal inefficiency happening here and it's probably not going to work very well, which led us to plan number three. Just use a water block. It makes really good contact with the liquid inside the loop, and the bit that touches the peltier is designed to maximize thermal exchange. So this should work very well. Now, step number one is digging the remnants of the custom loop out of this system, something which I should have done 2.5, maybe 3 years ago. So I'm hoping that we don't have a copious amount of mold going on the inside of this loop, because it's just been sitting closed like this for ages. Let's find out. No way, this stuff actually kind of looks fine on first impression. You can see the liquid in here is still clear, and even inside the block, like, that looks fine. Cool, so no consequences for my negligence. Nice. Luckily, removing the loop that was neglected like a birthday gift bonsai was surprisingly easy. Ooh, look at that dust filter. Gross. And then this, I think, should just lift out. It does, that's cool. Okay, so here is our loose loop that is, it's still filled with liquid. I'm obviously gonna drain it because I'm not gonna use this configuration. Now, considering that I'm gonna be cooling a relatively low wattage graphics card with it, I'm just gonna use the 240mm radiator. We'll take the 360 out, and then we're gonna attach our peltier to the CPU block. But with that, let me quickly drain this, take it apart and have a closer look. But, I mean, honestly, all the liquid and stuff is clean. I just used distilled water with an additive in it to stop bacterial growth, and apparently that really helped. Okay, so I'm just gonna drain it into this bucket. Like, surely that'll be fine, right? Oh, there we go. Oh! Ooh. That was almost a disaster. So with the loop very professionally drained, next I had to add a water block to the graphics card. Now, in terms of graphics card, I'm gonna use this RX 7600 for the entire reason I happen to have a GPU block for it right here. So let's install that so that we can get our loop up and running. Okay, Okay, well, there we go. We don't have, like, backplate on here and stuff, but it's fine. We don't need that for our experiment. Okay, so now I just need to figure out how we're gonna run this. I mean, does this just go in like that? I mean, the problem with running it like that is we have to fill the reservoir, is what I was gonna say. And in the process of trying to find an alternative, I made a little bit of a mess.
Oh, that's a lot of liquid.
Yeah, perfect timing. That's all drained already. Very good. And soon after that, I found an easy solution to the problem. Just put it on a box.
There we go. That's perfect.
I think this is genius. I think this is genuinely a really smart way to do this. I don't know how we're gonna drain it, but that's honestly not really an issue. Now the next step is to fill our loop, and this may be delusional levels of wishful thinking, but depending on how well our peltier implementation works here, I'm thinking normal water may be a bit of an issue, because it might actually freeze in the loop. Now, I have no idea if we're gonna get anywhere near to those levels of cooling, but I wanna be prepared for that. So instead of water, I'm gonna use vodka as a coolant. I bought this polar ice plastic bottle vodka, which seems like it's the highest quality liquor available, which will give us way more headroom in terms of below freezing temperatures for our coolant in this loop. Oh yeah, this will put some testes on your chest. Look at that. Okay, now I think my funnel's at home, so instead I'm gonna use this vacuum attachment where I duct taped all of the air holes closed on it. I think it should be fine. This seems very professional. Oh yeah, actually, before I start pouring some vodka into my loop, I do need to plug the pump in so that I can kind of cycle it. I don't know, this feels really stupid on several levels. Oh, I mean, it smells like antifreeze, so I'm sure this is the perfect application for it. But now we just need to turn the power supply on to... At this point, I was a little bit suspicious that the reservoir level didn't drop, but I heard pump sounds, so...
I think it's just full already. I bought way too much vodka.
But immediately after the system posted, I noticed something weird.
A few moments later.
Oh, I may have made a really big mistake here. I was wondering why the GPU was getting super hot, despite the fact that the pump was at full speed, and I wasn't really seeing any liquid movement through it. But the reason for that is because that has to be the outlet. That's the only outlet. So what I'm doing at the moment is using two inlets, so there's no actual liquid moving through the loop. I was really confused why this level didn't drop at all. So because of my polar ice induced psychosis, I now had to drain the loop with all of that PC nearby. Oh, it smells like underage drinking. Oh my god. Which is a joke that's obviously very naughty. Oh, so much vodka on my hands.
How is it not marked on the pump? Can we just blame Corsair a little bit here?
And after double checking that I was 100% using the correct hole this time, I was ready to dive in.
That makes a lot more sense. That's much more in line with what I was expecting. Yeah, the pump is actually moving liquid now.
So our loop has been running for an hour now, and it's topped out at 49 degrees Celsius. And you can feel the loop has definitely saturated in heat. It's all warm and stuff. So this is our target to beat with our peltier mod. Now I'm gonna start off with the peltier that I used in the previous video. It's not a super high wattage one, it didn't work for a 200 watt graphics card in the last video, but it's not having to cool the entire load by itself. So I'm curious to see how this one stacks up compared to a much more powerful one, which we'll try afterwards. But the idea here is pretty straightforward. I'm just gonna kinda wedge this between that block and a 420mm AIO to keep the hot side as cold as possible. Now my first attempt at mounting was to use the standard AMD mounting on both blocks, but unfortunately the non-removable screws on the Corsair block wasn't long enough, which meant I had to resort to some good old clamps.
Wait, this might actually work. So I put this
and then add the second clamp.
Oh my god, I think that's actually worked. That looks mounted to me, I don't know.
It also looks absurd, but I think we've got pretty good contact. I mean, you can see the little peltier peeking through there.
I'm gonna turn the system on, run it for a bit, and then we'll turn the Peltier on and see what happens. So while Cyberpunk's busy launching, as it stands now, we're looking at 26 degrees Celsius. That is the temperature of our coolant in our loop.
And after flicking our Peltier on, the results weren't great.
Okay, well, if anything, our loop temp is still climbing.
I then double-checked to make sure that I had the correct side of the Peltier touching the water block. Which it was, it just wasn't helping.
Well, that's very disappointing. It's not making any difference at all. Even now, with no load on the GPU, the Peltier is still running and, well, the loop temperature is barely cooling down. So I'm thinking that there's so much thermal inefficiency going on here that it's just not doing anything. However, there is the idiot's solution to inefficiency, which is just overwhelming force. So what I'm going to try next is dropping in this 288 watt Peltier in between those two blocks and hoping that just the sheer might of this thing makes something interesting happen. Now, because this very powerful Peltier is just going to wildly overload a Molex connector, I'm not going to strap it to one because that would be a terrible idea. So what I'm going to do instead is use this IED of a desktop power supply I bought off Amazon. Apparently it's 1,000 watts and it costs like 70 bucks, I think. So this will be much safer than the Molex connector because we have some direct connections to the power supply. Unfortunately, the little Peltier cables won't go straight into these terminals, but it did come with these little extension-y bits which you connect to the banana plug on this end. So I think I'm gonna have to solder the connectors of the Peltier to this side, screw it onto that power supply, and then I think we're good.
Which started a 25-minute process of me trying to solder a cable to a massive piece of copper like some kind of idiot. I even added in my desolderer to try and get the copper bit hot enough for solder to melt on it, which very much didn't work.
Wait, what am I doing? Why don't I just screw them down on top of the cables?
An approach that worked much better.
Now, unfortunately, this Peltier is pretty big, so we're just gonna be cooling like the middle of it. I think we can make contact with most of it. Okay, everything is ready. I have familiarized myself with the multiple fire extinguisher options that I have available to me. I don't know, I feel like that switch is too close to things that are dangerous.
But despite the IED not detonating when I turned it on, even the 288 watt Peltier had no effect on the coolant temperature when I turned it on, which sent me into a deep depression. Clearly, the world is stupid, my ideas are stupid, and I deserve to suffer. But then I remembered seeing Peltier-based liquid chillers on Amazon. Maybe something made by a professional Amazon seller would be much more effective than my implementation.
So this is a commercial solution, and the word commercial is doing some heavy lifting here. But yeah, let's see if this works better.
And when I first fired it up, things were very promising.
Okay, temperatures are dropping. -7. Oh, it's like frosting up. It's so cute.
So with our proof of concept, I hooked up the two Peltier coolers that I bought.
I can use the power supply as a rest for the radiator, because there's no issue mixing water and power supply. As I sarcastically say that, I realize that even for my level of negligence, that's too much.
But that didn't end up being the problem.
Yeah, the fact that it fits in that tube is not a good sign. Oh bother, that's a big issue. The problem is this tube also has been wildly savaged. Not even almost. This is what a sexual encounter with me must be like. That's crazy.
So I had to order some tighter fittings online.
The next day.
Yay, it's finally come. I just need to see now if these fittings actually fit. And then that goes over like that. That's perfect.
However, I discovered a bit of a whoopsie when I refilled up the loop.
Oh my god, the radiator is leaking. Where is it leaking from?
When I replaced the fitting, I accidentally pulled out the little buffer fitting thing in the radiator, which meant the new fitting didn't fit securely. But after lots of swearing and my office now smelling like a bar after St. Patrick's Day, I was ready to test the third setup.
Okay, so we're set up for our next level experiment, We've got 22C on the liquid. We've got no leaking in the loop, so that's very good.
I'm gonna turn this on and hope that it doesn't explode. Both of them turned on.
Now let's see if they do anything to the temperature of the loop. It's not a super promising start, I will say.
Skeptical, I fired up Cyberpunk and let the game run until the GPU temperature stopped climbing. And it actually plateaued at a lower temperature. Granted, it's just about 6 degrees Celsius lower, which is a tiny reduction in temperature for the 240 watts it's costing us, but at least it worked a little bit.
This one is barely cold. This one is slightly colder.
So I think it would be the kind of thing where I would need to have like 6 of them.
So with that, what did we learn in today's video? Well, apparently peltier cooling is extremely inefficient for PC use case, which I guess explains why basically no one uses it. Having said that, subscribe to the channel if you want to see me hooking up like 6 of these to a loop and seeing what will happen. And until the next video, thank you for watching. Bye-bye.